Welcome to Understand the Math. Today I'm going to teach you all about something fundamental and incredibly useful in algebra and calculus, parent functions. Understanding these basic building blocks can make complex mathematics problems a lot easier to solve. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can use while you watch this video. The notes contain the graph of each parent function, and you can write comments about the functions as we talk about their graphs, their equations, and their properties. Before we go over the 13 parent functions that all students studying precalculus or calculus should know, we need to talk about why you actually need to know these parent functions. Parent functions form the foundation for understanding more complex functions. They are the basic shape behind many more complicated functions, which are often the transformations of these parent functions. Knowing these parent functions will make you more efficient when solving problems. Identifying the type of function that you're working with can simplify the process of finding solutions. Parent functions are also used in modeling many physical phenomena that arise when solving real-world problems in science, engineering, and many other fields. Let's now dive into the 13 parent functions that you need to know. You should become familiar with their graphs, their equations, and key properties, and I'll go over all of this. The first function that we'll go over is the constant function. It's described by the equation y is equal to c and is defined for all values of x. It's a horizontal line with a slope of 0 and is the same for all values of x. Our second function is the linear function. It's described by the equation y is equal to x, and it's a straight line passing through the origin. It has a slope of 1 and is defined for all values of x. The third function is the quadratic function. It's defined by the equation y is equal to x squared. It's a parabola opening upwards with its vertex at the origin. It's an even function, which makes it symmetric about the y-axis, and it's defined for all values of x. Our fourth function is a cubic function, and is defined by the equation y is equal to x cubed. The graph of this function passes through the origin and changes concavity at the origin. It changes from concave down to concave up, and it's defined for all values of x. The fifth parent function is the absolute value function. It's described by the equation y is equal to the absolute value of x. It's a V-shaped graph with the vertex located at the origin. It's an even function, which makes it symmetric about the y-axis, and it's defined for all values of x. The sixth function is the square root function. This function is described by the equation y is equal to the square root of x. It's defined only for x greater than or equal to 0, and the graph of this function increases gradually as you go toward the right. The seventh function is the cube root function, and it's described by the equation y is equal to the cube root of x. This function is the inverse of the cubic function. It's an odd function, and just like the cubic function, it's symmetric about the origin. It's defined for all values of x. The eighth function is the reciprocal function, and is described by the equation y is equal to 1 over x. It's not defined at x is equal to 0 and has an asymptote there, and is only defined for x is greater than 0 and x is less than 0. It has two branches, one in the first quadrant and one in the third quadrant, and it is an odd function and symmetric about the origin. Our ninth and tenth functions are related to each other. Our ninth function is the exponential function, and the tenth function is the logarithmic function. These two functions are inverses of each other. The exponential function is defined by the equation y is equal to a to the x, and the logarithmic function is defined by the equation y is equal to log base a of x. The exponential function is a rapidly increasing function, is always positive, passes through the point 0, 1, and has a horizontal asymptote at y is equal to 0 or the x-axis. It's defined for all values of x. The logarithmic function is only defined for x greater than or equal to 0, is a curve that slowly increases, and has a vertical asymptote at x is equal to 0. It passes through the point 1, 0. Our last three parent functions are trigonometric functions. I have a whole series of videos on trigonometry if you want to know more details about these functions. The sine function is defined as y is equal to sine x. The graph of the sine function is a wave-like pattern oscillating between 1 and minus 1. It's an odd function and symmetric about the origin and has a period of 2 pi. That means that the function repeats every 2 pi units. The cosine function is defined as y is equal to cosine of x. The graph of the cosine function is also a wave-like pattern oscillating between 1 and minus 1. It's an even function and symmetric about the y-axis, and just like the sine function, has a period of 2 pi. The last function is the tangent function. It's defined as y is equal to tangent x. The function has vertical asymptotes at pi over 2 and every pi units to the right and to the left. It's similar in shape to the cubic function, is an odd function, and is symmetric about the origin. Now that you've seen all these parent functions, I would suggest that you practice drawing the graphs so that you'll be better prepared to work with more complicated functions that have the same basic shape as these functions. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.